Nimitta matram bhava savya sachin.
Asmatva mutishta.
Krishnaya Chola Bhasva.
Tathagata Krishnaya Chola Bhasva.
Jitva Shatrubhum Sharajam Samridham.
Jitva Shatrubhum Sharajam Samridham.
Maya Vaitai Nihanta Purva Vaiva.
In the field. Thus Arjuna is addressed as an expert warrior capable of delivering arrows to kill his enemies. Just become an instrument, nimitta matram. This word is also very significant. The whole world is moving according to the plan of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Foolish persons who do not have sufficient knowledge think that nature is moving without a plan, and all manifestations are but accidental for nations. There are many so-called scientists who suggest that perhaps it was like this, or maybe it was like that. But there is no question of perhaps or maybe. There is a specific plan being carried out in this material world. What is this plan? This cosmic manifestation is a chance for the conditioned souls to go back home, back to Godhead. As long as they have the domineering mentality, or the dominating mentality, which makes them try to lord it over material nature, they are conditioned. But anyone who can understand the plan of the Supreme Lord and cultivate Krishna consciousness is most intelligent. The creation and destruction of the cosmic manifestation are under the superior guidance of God. Thus, the battle of Kurukshetra was fought according to the plan of God. Arjuna was refusing to fight, but he was told that he should fight in accordance with the desire of the Supreme Lord. Then he would be happy. If one is in full Krishna consciousness and his life is devoted to the Lord's transcendental service, he is perfect. Also read the next verse. Dronam cha bhishmam cha jayadratam cha kalam tatanyam api yodaviram mayahatam svam cha imaryatishta yudashna chetasi rane sapatnam. Translation. Dronam bhishma jayadratam karna and the other great warriors have already been destroyed by me. Therefore, kill them and do not be disturbed. Simply fight and you will vanquish your enemies in battle. Every plan is made by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but he is so kind and merciful to his devotees that he wants to give the credit to his devotees who carry out his plan according to his desire. Life should therefore move in such a way that everyone acts in Krishna consciousness and understands the Supreme Personality of Godhead through the medium of the spiritual master. The plans of the Supreme Personality of Godhead are understood by his mercy, and the plans of the devotees are as good as his plans. One should follow such plans and be victorious in the struggle of existence. That's it. Tasmatma mutishta yashola pasva chitvaja trun bhukshva racham samritam mayayvate nihata purvameva nimitta matram bhavasavya sachin. Therefore get up, prepare to fight and bring glory, conquer your enemies and enjoy a flourishing kingdom. They are already put to death by my arrangement, and you, O Savyasachi, can be but an instrument in the fight. Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Nanda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shri Vasati Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So in the previous sloka or verse, Krishna told to Arjuna, I am the time. Kala Asmi. The time is, time means past, the present, and the future. That's the effect of the time. In the spiritual world, there is not an influence of the time, because there everything is in eternal presence. That means there's no past and there's no future. Everything is living in full cognitions and full presence. That means in the real reality. In the material world, we think I live in reality, but actually we don't. Because if we consider what is reality, where is our, then consider where your mind is. Now, right now, what do you think? You're directly present on the class, or you think something what happened already in the past, even a few minutes ago, or seconds ago, or yesterday, or something what you had in mind before you came here, or you think something in the future, maybe about a feast to eat after maybe 8 o'clock. Oh, you hope the lecture will not be too long on the slideshow on the Arctic, so that the feast I can eat nicely, peacefully, that I can digest it until tomorrow morning. So that means it will be on time. So we think about the future. So it's always actually, it's a fact that we all live, the mind always lives either in the past or in the future, not in the presence. So either we are, that means we are always in the daydreams. We're dreaming either in the past or in the future. We are not in the reality. Because the reality means to live in the now. Yes, now. That is Krishna. So therefore Krishna, he wanted to wake up Arjuna. Stop your dreaming about the past or about the future. Give up your sentiment, you know, your selfish compassion. For all these warriors here. Because I have showed you the universal form already, the Virarupa. And what you have seen, what is in this, what this universal form contains? Everything. The past, the present, and the future. Because Krishna is the time. Is Kala. That means simultaneously when Krishna revealed the universal form, the Kala aspect was also shown. Because when the material creation starts to exist or to go in the move from the avyakta, comes to the creation, Prakriti becomes created or manifested. From the Pradhana, from the unmanifested stage, from Mahavishnu. So he's glancing over the over Prakriti, over the material nature, with his transcendental glance. And he also puts his Kala aspect in it, the time. Because if the time is not in the creation, in the material world, creation cannot take place. Because a creation has a beginning, a middle, and an end. And for that, the time is needed. In the spiritual world, there's no creation because there everything is eternal, nitya. But in the material world, everything that is created has a beginning, a middle, and an end. That was Krishna telling in the beginning from the Bhagavad Gita and his teachings. They are not this body. And he says, you know, everything, every body who takes birth in this world also has to die. And everyone who will start and who will die, it is certain he will take birth again, somewhere. Either in the material world, or he will have the last birth, or the last life, or how say it, without any more birth, in the spiritual world. Where he become eternal associate of Krishna. That is the goal. That's the goal. But most of the people, they're not ready for that goal, because they want to use their time, you know, to find somehow a fortune here in this material world, in the future. If not now, in the future. So we're thinking and planning in this direction. So Krishna, he manifested this universal form. First, he just showed his different energies, his power, vibhuti, vibhutis, the different demigods who represent him, like the Surya, Somas, Bhun, the Ashwini, Kumaras, and so on and so on. There are many, many demigods in the material world. They all have their power by the Lord. They're in charge of the different senses and activities of the people in the world, so that the material affair can go on. But then, suddenly, Krishna changed the movie. From the creation and maintenance of universe, suddenly he showed the aspect of this complete destruction. It means a complete horror movie. He showed, you know, suddenly these thousand mouths, you know, of the universal form start to become like monster. You know, opening mouth with heavy teeth, you know, and all the creatures, everyone, the demigods, the forefathers, and all the warriors in the Kurukshetra war, Arjuna saw that they became swallowed by the universal form. So Arjuna was completely terrified. He was so much in shock. He was in the paralyzed with open mouth. Like Govardhan this morning. He saw something and he heard something what he never has seen or heard. Arjuna was in shock. He was in shock. He didn't know. He could not think properly anymore. He lost his identity. And he lost his identity with his friend, whom he considered friend before, you know, Krishna. Krishna is in Arjuna, they're very well known as friends. Sakya, Krishna Sakha. Arjuna asked, he lost identity, he had got identity crisis. Not only of himself, also of this personality. He asked, who are you? I never know you like that before. Before you always were friendly with me, joking together, picnicking, eating together, playing together, sporting together, like that. But now I see, you know, you become completely angry. And the anger aspect, I never know in you. Because you're Krishna, you're sober, you're a gentleman. And even if you become angry, you know, your eyes become like lotus. Still very attractive. So you don't show this angry mood. And still you look like a lotus, very beautiful, very attractive. But now I see all these fierce faces that don't look like you. But I ask you, please show me your universal form. Is this really you? And then Krishna says, yes, it's my aspect, kala, the time. Who is devouring everyone, cannot be stopped, because this was manifested during the creation. Because without the time aspect, the creation cannot take place. There's no life in this material world without the time. If you don't like the time, you're not here, then you're in Vaikuntha, in the spiritual world, in eternal presence. But here, we choose the way of life, because we turn the back against the Lord, and then we come in contact with the shadow energy, with Prakriti, with Maya. But the Maya is not our real shelter, it's not our real identity, although we accept Maya as the real identity, but actually it's illusion, because it has a beginning, middle and an end. It has no reality. We have to change it. We have to give it up one time, but because we become attached. We become attached to this Maya, to this material body, and to other material bodies. And we think we take this as all in all. And therefore we suffer. Therefore we have to take birth again and again. Here Arjuna is lamenting, oh, now I see, everyone will die. And Krishna told him, yes, everyone will die. Only you five brothers, the Pandavas and the few others, they will survive. Jayadrat, Bhishma, Karna, Drona, all these great warriors, Maharatas and Atiratas, they all will die. So Arjuna was surprised, because Arjuna had two dilemmas. a big dilemma. This head was split in two. First of all, he thought, how can I kill Bhishma, Drona, especially, because they're my seniors, they're my teachers, they're my guru. Guru means respectable personalities, authority. So I cannot kill them. That's good. I will create a sinful act in this way. And the other thing is, how can I, even if I want to kill them, how I can actually kill them? Because we all know Bhishma's story. He got the blessing of his father. He can choose in his own time and when he wants to die. And if Bhishma doesn't want to die, then I, Arjuna, even with the Gandiva bow, cannot kill him. And even with Krishna's presence, I cannot kill him. Because Bhishma is so powerful that he can decide himself when I want to die. Right? That's Bhishma's blessing that he got from his father. Because he was his father, he had this power to give somebody blessing, you know, that he will choose his own time when he wants to go. Other problem is Jayadrat. Jayadrat got from blessing from his father, as you maybe know. And that was the blessing. Whoever will cut your head, my dear son, you know, and when that head will throw on the ground, you know, that person will explode. So what Arjuna should do? Arjuna, even if I kill Jayadrat, you know, if his head will drop down, you know, I am also finished. Then he is finished and I'm finished. Gichai. Try both. So he thought, how is it possible, you know? That means we kill us both. And also Karna is considered invincible because he got the Shakti veteran who cannot be stopped and this weapon can destroy anyone. So and so, Drona. Drona, such an Atira, the guru of all the Kauravas, the old teacher, who was such a powerful personality, such a clever martial art man. He knew all the techniques, everything, you know. He knew. So how to kill him? How is it possible? How can the disciple be better than the guru? Not possible. So Arjuna, he thought, how I can kill Drona? And Drona knew even arts, science of art, of weapon. No, I don't even know. So he has all kinds of tricks on the side to remove me if he wants. He didn't call me. So Krishna, he knew the mind of Arjuna. Because they were one soul in two bodies. Because Arjuna, Krishna, eternal, they are together. So they came, you know, they removed the burden of the world. External, the mission of them. To remove the burden of the world. So Krishna knew the mind and therefore he wanted to clarify this for Arjuna and tell him, don't worry about all these warriors, don't have sympathy or compassion, because it's in the wrong place now, on the battlefield. They anyway all assembled here to kill you, and if you not kill them, you know, they will anyway kill you, and if you run away from them, they anyway will become killed. That's what Krishna is saying. Anyway, because they got the death sentence. Yeah, understand? Death sentence. Like somebody was condemned to death in America, a murderer. No. Okay, death sentence. Or in China, or in other countries, Muslim country, Arabic country. No, finish. And they decide, okay, finish. They don't give you a chance to improve, because there is no improvement for them, because they are too much offensive. Drona, Karna, and all of them, they were too much offensive towards Draupadi and to the Pandavas. They cannot be forgiven. The Pandavas may be forgiven, especially you this year. He's Achata Shatru, he has no enemy. Never, any enemy never born in his mind, animosity. So he will forgive, he already forgave, but Krishna doesn't forgive. Devotee forgive, but Krishna not. Therefore, if you offend the devotee, if you commit offense to the devotee, the devotee forgive, but Krishna not. Krishna will think about that. He doesn't forget. He remembers. So therefore, we also have to be careful and not to don't offending devotees. Not hurting devotees. Because they are all instrumental in the mission of the spiritual master, of Srila Prabhupada, and of the Sankirtan movement of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Mahaprabhu is Krishna himself, and he declared, yes, his Sankirtan movement will be spread all over the world, and every one of you can become instrumental if you join the Acharya and follow my instruction coming from the Guru Parampara. You will become empowered. Like Arjuna became empowered. Nimitta Matam Bhavasa Vashachi Sabhavasa Samyasachi. So therefore Krishna convinced Arjuna, you become instrumental. I already made the plan. It's already decided. And the plan will be fulfilled with you or without you. You can choose now. You want to become instrumental and fight? Stand up. Utishta, rise up. Wake up. Utishta. It's a wake up formula in Sanskrit, you know. Wake up, please wake up from your dreaming stage of mind. And take up your duty and fight. Perform your mission. And Arjuna's mission was not Sankita man or a pujari or a cook or a householder. His mission was a warrior. That was his duty. That is what is Varna. He was Kshatriya. So he could not become Brahmana, non-violent, Om Shanti Shanti, offering oblations to the fire, you know, and live a peaceful life, and studying scriptures, and be charitable and accept charity. Never in mind in Kshatriya. He had to fight, he had to perform his duty. If he will not perform his duty, you know, his fame would come over him, and it will spread. All the Kshatriyas will laugh about him, joke about him, ridicule him, and think, what kind of Kshatriya is he? Nonsense. This Arjuna. And in this way, this will be very hurting to you. Krishna told him in the beginning, in the second chapter, Bhagavad Gita, it will be very hurting. It's worse than that. Somebody was glorious, a hero like you, who already won so many battles. If you would run from the battlefield and give up your fight, give up your duty. And if you fight, then you will become glorious, you become famous. Yashaha. Yashaha means famous. Like Yashoda. Mother of Krishna is Yashoda because he makes the cowherd community in Vrindavan famous. So Yasha. So, and Krishna wants to make his devotees famous. He's already famous. One of the qualities of Krishna is Yasha. Yes, he's Bhagavan. He has six qualities. One of these qualities is Yasha. What is the beginning? Is Aishwarya, Vyaryasya, Aishwaryasya, Samagrasya, Vyaryasya. Here is somebody know? Saman. Beauty, Shri. power and fame, renunciation, vairagya, and knowledge, jnana. Aishvaryasa, samakrasya, viryasa, yasasa ashriya, yasasa ashriya, jnana vai vairagyas chaiva, these six opulences are fully manifested in Krishna. So Krishna is already world famous. Even the atheists always speak about God in a negative way. That means that everyone knows about the glories of God. Negative or positive. It's not a problem for Krishna. Because everything what you speak about Krishna, negative or positive, is positive. It will purify yourself. Therefore, when Lord Chaitanya appeared and the Holy Name appeared with him, everyone was chanting Hari Hari, or mocking. The Muslims were mocking the Vaishnavas, were chanting Krishna Ratnam, or Hari, or Rama, mocking each other. So they became purified. They became purified. Even unconsciously, unknowingly. So Krishna is most famous, but he wants to make his devotees famous. He wants to give the credit to his devotee. Therefore he empowers the devotee. He could do it himself. He already made the plan, the master plan. And he made already all arrangements. And so now he gives the in charge to the devotee and says, okay, tells you, you go, you do that and fulfill this mission. And then you become glorious, you become famous. Although the devotee doesn't want to become famous, he wants to make Krishna famous. But he accepts the fame to make Krishna famous. And Krishna also doesn't want to become famous, but he accepts the fame that his devotee become famous. So because Krishna and devotee, they are a team. One heart, one interest. Therefore, unity is unity in interest. In interest with the plan of God, the Krishna. If we make our own plan according to our interest, then we are in diversity. But if we accept Krishna's plan, make that plan, and Acharya's plan, making our plan, because Acharya knows what is Krishna's desire, then our life will become perfect. And if we do whatever we like, then we fall on the nose. Then we fall on the nose. Then we get reaction. But as long as you work on behalf of Krishna, there's no reaction. There's action without reaction. This karma is an action without any reaction. There's no karma in devotion, in bhakti, in Krishna karma. For activities and for the pleasure of Krishna, there's no karma. Anything else has karma, positive or negative. But Krishna karma has only positive, transcendental result. And so Krishna therefore has the plan, and he gives this to his devotee. And Lord Chaitanya, Krishna also came as Lord Chaitanya. He gave the same order also to the devotees, to his devotees, because he told, this time I didn't brought any weapon with me, I have no anger with me, I have no destructive ideas. Although in Kali Yuga everyone should become destroyed, but Krishna thought, because I come in the mood of a devotee, and the devotee is always more merciful, more compassionate than the Lord himself. So he thinks, I will not kill them. I will not kill their bodies, but I will kill their demoniac propensities. I will purify their consciousness and will them out and drown them in the ecstatic love of my own love towards the inhabitants of Vrindavan and the inhabitants of Vrindavan to Krishna. That love I want to spread. And that love I want to drown everyone. That was Lord, that is Lord Krishna's plan. In form of Lord Chaitanya, Gauranga Mahaprabhu. And Lord Chaitanya said already the plan And he requested everyone to execute this order, this mission. Take this on your head and meditate about it. Become instrumental in spreading the Sankirtan movement in every town and village all over the world. This is Lord Chaitanya's master plan. And everyone who is participating in it, who takes a part in it, or supports this mission, they become glorious. Lord Chaitanya himself will become glorious, because he told, now I am a gardener, I am a mali of this Chaitanya tree, of my Sankirtan movement, and it has so many wonderful fruits of love of Godhead, but I am only one person. How much I can relish, how much I can enjoy of all these fruits, nectarian fruits. Therefore he requested all his devotees, please take as many fruits as you can and eat yourself, become intoxicated by love of Godhead, and this fruit will, this tree will give so many more fruits. So if you are satisfied and happy in this ecstatic mood of Krishna consciousness, then you give it to others. That's how Krishna consciousness spreads. Krishna consciousness doesn't spread from emptiness, from empty heart and consciousness. It comes from love for Krishna. Therefore, by love for Krishna, Krishna consciousness will spread. Not from nothingness, not from material qualities. Material qualities will fail to spread Krishna consciousness. We tried it out. The books were given to professional booksellers. They could not distribute one book. Professional Sankirtan man who sing very professional the music, but they cannot make one devotee. Because they're not empowered. They're not instrumental in the hands of Lord Chaitanya. And if we don't accept Lord Chaitanya and Nityananda, and also the Vaishnavas, the followers of Lord Chaitanya and Nityananda, if we don't accept them as our life and soul, and to become humble servants of them, instrumental in their mission, serving their lotus feet, we are useless. Although maybe you have a high education, very intelligent, very capable, but we are all useless. If the Lord is not using us as an instrument. And Lord Chaitanya gives everyone the opportunity. His Mahavadani avatar is very, very merciful. Everyone is not making any restriction. He is qualified, not qualified. Because of Vaidyacharya, as you heard yesterday, when Lord Chaitanya asked him, what is your desire? Why you called me? I want to give you a blessing, fulfill your desire. Advaitacharya, he told, my desire is, when you spread Sankirtan movement, don't spread it only to the qualified person, also distribute it to the women, to the Shudras, to the Vaishyas, Yavanas, to everyone, outcast, to the higher and to the lower. And then Lord Chaitanya happily said, yes, that's the plan, and you spoke what is in my heart, it will happen like that. And we can see in the practical way that Sankirtan movement will spread, and we can participate in it, we can support it for some time, as long as we have the time for it, we can become instrumental and glorious, and then after we're going or retire, maybe in old age, going to the next place where the Lord wants to have you, then the Sankirtan movement will go on, and Krishna will send new devotees. Lord Chaitanya will send new personalities who are able to continue with the mission and with this Sankirtan process. Because Prabhupada told that the next 10,000 years is Sankirtan will go on, not just for the next 10 more years. So, next 10,000 years. So here in Croatia and Zagreb, we can be very positive. The movement will go on. So also, with you or without you, it will go on. And now you are here, you have the good opportunity, the great privilege to participate in the movement. And get the credit, get the mercy of Srila Prabhupada and Guru Parampara and Shisi Gonitai and Radha Krishna Balaram, and in this way your life will be perfect. Hare Krishna, Hare
Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Thank you, glorious Prabhupada. Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Gita. So now we have Goradik, and after Goradik, don't run away. I will already give you the program for the future. Next half an hour after Kirtan will be a slideshow about Krishna Balaram Mandir. It's only short one, about 20 minutes. I showed yesterday one, today is the second part. And then is the feast. Hopefully at 8 o'clock. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Die.